Welcome to Heidi Relationships. Today, we'll read some more stories from Reddit. But before we start, I would really appreciate if you could subscribe to the channel, like the video if you enjoyed it, and maybe leave a comment down below. That would help the channel a lot. Thank you very much in advance.
The first one is titled, My Girlfriend Cheated on Me with Her Best Friend. During the summer break, my girlfriend cheated on me with her best friend, all the while keeping me in the dark and the general communication was zero. We came back to college, and I started hearing dumb things and excuses that lead to fights like, You kiss differently. You've changed. You're not who you were. I haven't changed a bit, it's just that something felt off. One day we had an event in college and we had a lot of fun. The same night I got a call from her, she was crying, and she told me how she cheated on me with her best friend for about 3 months. She told me how she realized she truly loved me. I don't like shouting on people or fighting, so I immediately cut the call and didn't want to talk further. She started bombarding me with calls. I picked up one call and told her that I didn't want to talk right now and was in no mood to discuss this further. She kept calling me. Now her friends also joined in. I was getting messages and calls left and right. She was crying and not eating. Finally, I had to pick up the call. She was crying profusely and asking me why I wasn't talking to her. She kept saying I love you, but I couldn't bring myself to reciprocate. I told her I wanted to break up, but that blew the lid off her and she started crying very loudly. I somehow convinced her to eat something and not cry. She kept saying she only wanted me and nothing else. But my trust was shattered. She made me meet her the next day, although I didn't want to. I told her I wanted a break and it'll be a long time before I was normal again. She just kept crying and asking me not to do this. She kept saying I love you, don't do this, etc. After a while I thought maybe I was being too dramatic and told her I can't trust her anymore. She said she would do anything. I could only tell her I can't do this. She kept pushing me. Me and my ex were really good friends. We broke up on mutual terms and would talk once in a while. She had a problem with talking to my ex and made me block her. Finally, I asked her to choose between me or her best friend. I'm not someone who does something like this. She used to hang out with him and leave me behind, talk to him and not answer my calls at times, but I trusted her fully. She said she wants to be with me. She made it a point to show me she blocked him. It was all well and good until about a week later when I saw she was talking to him on Instagram. I was hurt. I had started to trust her again to some degree. I immediately confronted her, and she blocked him again, but I wasn't having any of it. She started crying and begging me. After a lot of this, I still agreed to be with her. Now yesterday, again I saw this guy's chats, never checked her phone. She was showing me something on Instagram and confronted her about it immediately. She started telling me how her friend was becoming suicidal and this and that. I called the guy directly and talked to him in front of her and told both of them that I wasn't okay with it and that she will have to choose. Now somehow my girlfriend told me I was being controlling by asking her to choose, and at this point I had had enough. I asked her to take her stuff and go to her hostel. I have a flat. She lives in the hostel. Now I thought talking to one of her friends who was quite reasonable was a good idea. I called her friend up in front of her and she told my girlfriend to do what she thought was right. Then she took the phone off the speaker and I was like, this involves me, I would like to listen. At this point she started leaving the room. She had already packed her stuff, so in anger I told her that if you leave just don't come back. At this point she made up her mind about the breakup and proceeded to take her stuff and walk out the door. It was pretty late at night and I didn't want to let her go in an unsafe situation. I chased after her and said I'd give her a ride. She refused but I insisted. Finally, she agreed. At this point she had told her friends and her best friend that we've broken up. But during the ride she held on to me and started crying, asking me if we were really doing this. I didn't have an answer. What do I do? A user in the comments said, you deserve better. Sounds like you will be happier on your own for a bit. What really grinds is she was perfectly happy giving you the ultimatum to block your ex, controlling in her own words. Yet when you ask the same, she's a victim. Walk away and be happy doing it. Another user said, If you ever feel like you can only trust a partner through almost controlling means, then there isn't any real trust left and no possible foundation for a healthy relationship. Also, her making you block the ex that you were genuinely friends with is a major red flag, and that she expects you to cut off friends she's not comfortable with but can't do the same also shows another level of disrespect. You can't trust her, and she doesn't respect you, so it's past time to go. The next one is titled, 1 Year Update, My Girlfriend, F20, Cheated on Me, M21, With Her Best Friend. So, I wanted to provide an update and thank my fellow Redditors. I took the advice and broke up and realized that the relationship was really sucking the life out of me and was the worst thing in my life at the moment. Since then, I have met someone who understands me and cares for me. There's no drama. Well, I once ate the last pizza slice and she got pretty angry, but yeah, that's the level of the drama. We support each other and she makes me a better human all around. Because of my ex, I wasn't able to focus on my studies, and the breakup combined with the pandemic gave me ample time for studying, and I landed an internship at a big bulge bracket company, and also I'm working on a few personal projects that I love spending time on. The pandemic also gave me time to realize that I was with the wrong person, and I love many others who love me, be it my family, friends. I feel really liberated. Today I was looking back at what used to be, and I remembered that this subreddit for the trigger point for the change in my life. So, thank you, and you all are awesome. It's because of you I've gone from crying nights to happy days. The next one is titled, I26F. Open my husband's 32 meters Snapchat, and it was a very explicit picture and caption from a girl. I've been with my husband for 5 years, married for 1.5. I've never once doubted his fidelity. He's great, super smart, funny, handsome, and, I thought, loyal. He's never given me reason to doubt him or be suspicious. I thought it was kind of odd when he downloaded Snapchat. He's not big on social media. I have one, but I'm not very active. We rarely snap each other. He said his friends were really active and he liked it better than Facebook, so. As I said, I've never had any reason not to trust him. So, I thought nothing of it. This morning, my husband was in the shower and left his phone on my nightstand. I was half asleep when his phone started chirping and woke me up. We both have the same phone and ringtone for text messages. Not knowing that he had put his phone on my nightstand for whatever reason, I thought it was my phone in my half-asleep state. Despite his black phone case, mine is green. I didn't even notice, and I looked at who had texted. It said, Mom, okay, my mom texted me, I can ignore that until I'm actually awake. But under that was a Snapchat notification. A snap from someone named, Roxy. I was like, who the F is Roxy and why is she Snapchatting me? I opened it and bam, it's a picture of a pussy. And not the meowing kind with four legs and a tail. The caption said, I want your tongue inside me again. Now, I immediately thought it was a mistake. But I was alert now after being awoken by a vulva. I pretty quickly realized that this was my husband's phone. I felt like I was going to crap the bed and started to sweat. I looked at his contacts on Snapchat and she has a yellow heart next to her name. I looked up WTF that means, and it means they are best friends. WTF. I feel like I'm going to be sick. I didn't do any other snooping because honestly, I know what I'll find. I just don't understand how he could do this. We're happy. I thought we were happy. We have sex at least 4 times a week. Here's the real kicker, Reddit. I'm almost 12 weeks pregnant with our first child. He's sitting in the recliner about 20 feet from me and I just can't find the words to confront him. How do I say what I need to say? There is no way I am somehow overreacting or misreading this situation, is there? I'm heartbroken and don't know what to do. Update. First and foremost, thank you all for your love and support. I feel it from here. Honestly, thank you, it's amazing to me that strangers care so much about my baby and me. Love back to all of you. So, husband knows something is up. I don't know if he saw that I opened a Snapchat from Roxy and is afraid of what I saw and afraid to bring it up, or if he's clueless and can just tell I'm upset about something. He's been asking me if I'm okay or if something is wrong about every hour. I told him my sister was having a hard time today. Ironically, she just broke up with her boyfriend. Why? He cheated. And I was going to go over to her place for dinner. I live in Pacific time zone, and to spend the night with her. I'm here now. My sister is 20 and a whiz at the social media thing. She stalked his Facebook to see if this Roxy person popped up anywhere. She looked through his friends' friends. Bingo, we found her. Well, at least pretty sure. I didn't see her face in the Snapchat. The screen was too full of her crotch. She's Facebook friends with my husband's good friend. She is listed as a receptionist at my husband's friend's law firm. My husband works a couple blocks from the law firm, and he stops by often to grab lunch with his friend. That would explain how they met. Still formulating a plan on confrontation, trying to get as much information as possible first. My sister wants to burn his life to the ground, and honestly I do too, but I'm going to address this in the most adult way possible so that I can walk away from him with my head held high and be a deserving role model to my baby girl. Not sure it's a girl, just a feeling. Good news? My uncle is a lawyer. Most of what he deals with are divorces. I've already contacted him and asked if we could discuss some potential legal issues, didn't specify what yet. Feels like something I should do in person during our meeting. I told him it was urgent, we are meeting tomorrow morning. I will try to update as much as I can and from the bottom of my heart, thank you all again, internet strangers. A user in the comments said, did I catch you in time? Please go to chumplady.com and prepare yourself. Your husband is cheating and he's going to pull all the standard cheater crap on you unless you arm yourself first. Edit. Right, you don't know what he'll do minimizing, blaming you for his choice to cheat, outright lies, rewriting the marital history that he was always unhappy, news to you I bet, and things like that. I had a friend recommend an infidelity site when my ex told me he had internet friends. I did not check it out. He ran roughshod over my shattered heart as a result. You want to get all your evidence gathered before you confront him. If you feel like you need to puke, you are pregnant, so use that. You can back up his phone and restore all texts, etc. I recommend you do that before you confront him. Buy the software if things really go south and you want to see WTF he has been up to. The next one is titled, Last Update to the Snapchat Husband Cheating Story. Again, I am overwhelmed by the support and love I've received from everyone. It feels great to be comforted and cheered on by you all. Thank you so much. So, husband cheated. He has been since, maybe 2 weeks before last Christmas, according to him. I was very calm when confronting him and took the advice many of you gave me by telling him that he needs to explain to me who Roxy is and why she is his best friend, on Snapchat. His face gave him away immediately, but he still tried to lie to me at first. He said that she works with his friend, and they met when his friend invited her out to lunch with the two of them. At first, he claimed he only met her about 2 months ago. He said that they're best friends, because he doesn't receive many Snapchats from others and she is extremely active on the app. He said she just sends randoms and is really into fitness, so she sends a lot of inspirational snaps on being healthy and living a better life. He said that every once in a while, he'll send her something back, like a picture of a cheeseburger or something just to tease her about her level of health consciousness. First, I asked why he didn't just tell me about her. He said he didn't even think about it because she's just an acquaintance, not even a friend. Then I asked if he'd ever received anything even remotely inappropriate from her. He answered with, not on purpose. I'm assuming he went with that because he knew I opened that Snapchat and he probably knew it was a bad one. I asked what, not on purpose, means. He got very defensive, started raising his voice and saying he doesn't need to explain what that means, that sometimes people accidentally send the wrong Snapchats to the wrong people. Then he had the nerve to say something along the lines of, I feel like I'm on trial here. People warned me that you'd get crazy when you're pregnant, but I never thought it'd be this bad. Now, as some of you mentioned in my last post, it seems amazing that I'm able to keep such a level head. That is because I was raised by a mother who always told me that you never accomplish anything with anger. That you can be emotional, passionate, upset, etc. without ever raising your voice. Messages received quietly and concisely are just as loud and clear as messages received through yelling and screaming. That is how I have lived my life for 26 years, with the exception of just a few blow-ups. I am human. This moment was an exception. I didn't exactly yell and scream, but I became furious. For him to try to blame this on me being pregnant. How unoriginal and offensive. Long story short, he said he'd never seen me this crazy and I told him that I'd never seen a picture of another girl's kitty on my husband's Snapchat before. He came back with that I shouldn't have looked at his Snapchat. I came back with that it was an accident, but even if it hadn't been, there shouldn't be any reason he's receiving Snapchats like that for me to see accidentally or not in the first place. I told him that I may be pregnant, but I'm also an intelligent person and I am his wife, so I knew he was lying, and I deserved to know the truth. I asked if I could see his text messages to see if he's been texting Roxy. He said sure. No messages. Then I asked to see his Facebook messages. He looked like a kid caught with his hand in the cookie jar. He told me no. I asked why. He finally broke and started to cry. Told me he couldn't let me see the messages because they would hurt me. Because they were inappropriate. Then it all came out. They screwed in the backseat of her car the first night they met. This is already long, so I'll spare you all the details. But it's been an ongoing affair for months. No, they did not always use protection. Although I was recently screened for STIs, I'll be getting checked again in light of this information. My uncle already assured me that if he was unfaithful, we would cream him in court. Really, the only thing I'm willing to fight him tooth and nail for is our home. I put a lot of effort and money into making this home my dream space. I won't be seeking spousal support, but I will seek child support. I'm obviously heartbroken and told him to go stay in a hotel or with Roxy for all I cared. I confronted him last night. My mom and sister stayed with me last night and let me sob all over them for hours. Right now, I'm sort of numb, but I'm also thinking very clearly. I know what my next 10 moves are and I feel supported and secure in my decision to leave him and keep my baby. A few things I just wanted to clarify. My husband is not a lawyer, his good friend is. There was some concern for my success in court if my husband is a lawyer. His friend is in environmental law, so, while I'm sure he can provide some advice, he will not be my husband's divorce lawyer. There were suggestions of me terminating my pregnancy. I fully support the right to choose, and I would probably terminate the pregnancy if I was in a different financial position and lacked a support system. However, I work as a marketing manager for a large company. Not only does this allow me the privilege of working from home about 50% of the time, but it also grants me financial independence. I do not rely on my husband for money, and I really never have. He works in tech, so, while he makes a good salary, I will have no need for spousal support. I have a phenomenal support system. This baby will be loved so dearly by so many. Yes, I will have to deal with my husband for the rest of my life if I have this child, and it will make future relationships for me more difficult, but it is worth it. I've wanted this baby since day one and I am her mother, which means that I am strong enough to raise her alone because I have to be strong enough. Here's to hoping for a speedy divorce. I'm ready to be done with this marriage. Which is crazy because just a few days ago I thought my life was as close to perfect as you could get. Update. I know it has been only a short time since I posted this update, but I need to tell you all how amazing all of you are. Wow, this much support is just wow. I wish I could reply to all of your comments and messages, but because of the volume, I'm just going to say thank you from the bottom of my heart to each and every one of you who read my posts, who commented, thought of me, wished my baby and me the best, messaged me, and anything else. I am currently at my parents' condo, sitting outside at their pool, sunbathing my little baby bump and reading each and every one of your amazing and empowering comments. I just want you all to have that image, that you have made me happy and content in a time when I am short on both. This is proof that love does exist, even if it doesn't within my, now over, relationship. And that is a powerful thing. Love to you all. Me again. I was going to post more details on what happened during the confrontation with my husband, etc., but then I decided against it. I should keep some details private. It's likely my husband has seen this post. I will leave you with this. My dad and I were up late talking last night, and as usual, he had the perfect thing to say to me. He told me that weak people are afraid of strong people. He told me to keep on terrifying the weak ones. That way, the only people who won't fear you are the bravest, strongest of people, and those are the people who are worthy of you. Then he said my husband is a spineless turd who couldn't kick it with the strongest woman in the world. Just thought I'd leave you with that and encourage everyone to be terrifying by being strong and not standing for nonsense. This is the last I will post on the matter. I have a lot ahead of me with everything and will probably go quiet on Reddit for a while. This is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed the relationship stories. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video and write a comment. I really appreciate your support and it helps my channel so much. Thank you.